Welcome back, and in this video I want to cover two things which are at the core of CloudFormation as a product: physical resources and logical resources. In covering both of those, you're also going to be learning about templates and stacks, so this will be a good video to cover the basics of CloudFormation. Now, we've got a lot to cover, so let's jump in and get started. CloudFormation begins with a template, which is a document written in either YAML or JSON, both of which you should now have an awareness of. And defined within a CloudFormation template are logical resources. Think of logical resources as what you want to create, but not how you want them created. When using CloudFormation, you focus on the what and let CloudFormation deal with the how. CloudFormation templates can be used to create CloudFormation stacks, and a template can be used to create one stack, 100 stacks, or 20 stacks in different regions. The idea is that one template defines what resources you want, and defining good templates means a template can be used many times in many accounts in many regions, and we refer to that as a portable template. The initial job of a stack is to create physical resources based on the logical resources defined within the template. For every logical resource in a template, when a stack is created, a physical resource is also created. If a stack's template is updated in some way, and then the stack itself is updated, the physical resources are also changed. The stack keeps the logical and physical resources in sync. If a stack is deleted, then normally the physical resources are also deleted. So think about CloudFormation as a product which looks at a template, specifically the logical resources within a template, and then it creates, modifies, or deletes physical resources as required. So visually, it looks like this. This is a CloudFormation template, and this one has been written using YAML. The template contains logical resources. In this example, instance is the name of the logical resource, and this is the type, so AWS EC2 instance. Now, logical resources are generally going to have properties which are used by CloudFormation when configuring the actual physical resources. In this example, this sets the Amazon machine image to use, the type of the instance, and the SSH key pair to use when connecting to the instance. So the collection of logical resources and other things which I'll be covering in future videos is called a CloudFormation template, and this template can be used to create one or many CloudFormation stacks, and a stack, when created, also creates physical resources based on the logical resources. So this means because we've set the AMI to use in the template and the SSH key to use, these will be used when creating the physical resource, in this case an EC2 instance. So this physical EC2 instance is a representation of the logical resource defined in the CloudFormation template. Now, the stack will also react to template changes to update or delete physical resources as required. Once a logical resource defined inside the CloudFormation template moves into a create complete state, meaning that the physical resource has been created, then the logical resource can be referenced by other logical resources to retrieve various physical configuration elements or IDs. For example, in this case, the physical machine ID of the EC2 instance. So in summary, logical resources are contained inside CloudFormation templates. CloudFormation templates are used to create CloudFormation stacks, and the stack's job is to create, update, or delete physical resources based on what's contained in that template. CloudFormation as a product aims to keep the two in sync, so physical and logical resources. So, when you use a template to create a stack, CloudFormation will scan the template and create a stack with logical resources inside, and then create physical resources which match those logical resources. If you update the template, then you can use it to update that same stack. When you do that, the stack's logical resources will change. Either new logical resources will be added, or existing ones are updated or deleted, and CloudFormation will perform the same actions on the physical resources, so adding new ones, updating existing ones, or removing physical resources entirely. Now, if you delete a stack, its logical resources are also deleted, which causes it to delete the matching physical resources. CloudFormation is a really powerful tool which you'll be using extensively in the real world, and this is the same whether you're a solutions architect, a developer, or an engineer. I use CloudFormation constantly in all of the AWS courses that I create, and so by taking the courses, you'll be gaining a lot of practical and theory understanding of how CloudFormation works. Now, if you're taking any of my courses with my CloudFormation mini deep dive, then you'll be learning even more. I'll be talking about every important aspect of CloudFormation that's relevant for the course that you're taking, as well as giving you plenty of practical examples. CloudFormation lets you automate infrastructure. Imagine that you host WordPress blogs. You can use one template to create 1, 10, 100, or more deployments rather than having to create 100 individual sites. CloudFormation can also be used as part of change management. You can store templates in source code repositories, add changes, and get approval before applying them. Or they can be used to just quickly spin up one-off deployments. And if you're taking any of my AWS courses, you'll be seeing that I'll be using CloudFormation extensively as part of any of the practical demo lessons in the course. We'll be using templates to spin up any of the infrastructure that will support the demo lesson that you're going to be taking. Now, that's all of the theory that I wanted to cover about physical and logical resources within CloudFormation. It is a fairly theoretical topic, but you need to understand what a physical resource is, what a logical resource is, and how the two relate together as far as they're used within CloudFormation. Now, at this point, that's everything that I wanted you to cover in this video, so go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.